This non-fireproof two-story house with a walkout basement will be used to demonstrate how rapidly a fire could spread through a flow path with a low intake vent and a high exhaust vent. A fire on the first floor can quickly spread to the second floor if the upstairs windows or skylights are open. In our scenario, the fire will start in the basement. Both sliding glass doors are open and the upstairs bedroom window is open. This is the windward side of the house. With the exposure 3 windows open, the wind will pressurize the rooms in the rear of the house. Note that the basement is connected to the first floor via a stairway. Closing the door at the top of the stairs can interrupt or control the flow path from the basement to the first floor. The flow path from the first floor is connected to the second floor by an open stairwell. There is no control point on the stairs, only doors to the individual rooms. Void spaces can also connect the upper floors of a house to the basement. Next, we will combine the house model with a computational fluid dynamics model, which shows the flow of fire gases and air along the flow paths in the structure. In this scenario, the basement door is serving as an air intake vent, which is on the same level as the fire. The front door and the upstairs bedroom window will be open. These will serve as vertical exhaust vents for the fire on the floor below. The rear is the windward side of the house. Winds as low as 10 miles per hour can aid in the spread of fire through a structure. A small fire is burning in the basement. The red areas are consistent with flame temperatures of 1,000 degrees Fahrenheit or higher. The dark blue areas are approximately 70 degrees or air temperature. The flow path is confined to the basement by the door at the top of the stairs. At this point, the sliding glass door in the rear is serving as both the intake and the exhaust vents. The failure of the basement stair door acts like a vertical vent and enables the flow path to extend to the open front door and up the stairway to the open front window on the second floor. Once the door failed, the fire only took seconds to move from the stairwell to the second floor. Note that the windward bedroom in the rear is relatively cool compared to the rest of the second floor. This is due to pressure from the wind and isolation from the flow path. Also note that the front bedroom, which is in the exhaust portion of the flow path, has reached temperatures estimated to be between 600 and 800 degrees Fahrenheit. These temperatures exceed the design limits of many PPE components. Size up is critical to identify the building geometry, the location, and the extent of the fire. During size up, recognize the potential flow paths in order to take action to prevent rapid flame spread throughout the structure. Control flow paths, especially those with an air intake on the fire floor and a high exhaust on the floor above, to limit the speed and growth of the fire. Fight the fire on its own level. Get the line to a position where it can be effective. For wind-impacted fires, keep the wind at your back. Understanding flow paths with low intakes and high exhausts enable the implementation of strategy and tactics that lead to successful outcomes.